just to share, both LCX and NLC, you know, they have their own shares in the newspapers. So they always, you know, bark on each other. You know. So sometimes it will be correct, sometimes it will not be correct. It's very important for all of you to take what is correct and what is not correct. So don't rely completely on the newspapers. So, and the unfortunate part is that the recent disturbance of the financial system, foreign exchange market, specific, there are two issues which is not really discussed and also not highlighted in the newspaper. It's something I wrote for the newspaper and as I said, they didn't publish. I would have written more than 100 newspaper articles, but this particular article haven't published, I am not able to publish for quite some time. Okay, this is the extent of biases that you see in the newspapers. And just to draw your attention to one of the presentations by Dr. Y.V. Reddy sometime in December in Basel, where he actually cites the kind of control, it's not the control to be only on the foreign financial markets, it should be also, we could also have control on this press. Media houses. So that is the main issue. All of you know that, you know, generally foreign exchange market is been growing in a big way in the international level. And I see the kind of transaction that is happening in the foreign exchange. I'm sure that all of you know this kind of trend, but I just thought highlight what are the role of financial market, particularly foreign exchange market in overall financial market by the end of the day. So in the third round, again they will go to the interbank leader and they hear there. In a sense, you start with the reference rate, sometimes at the end, you know, even central banks can intervene and try to absorb any kind of a surplus or deficit in the foreign exchange. That is, at the end of the day, you have to acquire what all your net foreign. This is how this market functions. Foreign market is recently here. It has really, rupee dollar exchange rate has depreciated. Yes. 1.3 or something like that, and rupee dollar exchange rate depreciated almost from 52 to 61.7 or something like that. So historically high depreciation that we have seen, almost 12% depreciation that we have seen in the forex market. But this is nothing new for India. Like you have seen the pre-crisis situation before 2008. Rupee dollar has appreciated by almost 24%. Okay. From 49, it has come to 36. So in a sense, this kind of fluctuations in the Indian foreign exchange market is not really new. If you have a data from 1992 or 93 onwards, you see that the rupee dollar is, I know, appreciating, depreciating in the last swing. I would say the market. Despite this being a managed kind of exchange rate regime that we have, okay? In India, what kind of regimes that we have, I mean, what are the regimes that are there in the literature? There are something called free float, there is a fixed exchange rate regime, okay? There is something called broad impact, and then you have something called management. So there are many other levels of regimes. But in India, we generally agree that we have a managed float where we allow the exchange rate to depreciate sometimes, and we try to stabilize at one particular rate. Okay. So, what led to such deficit? The question that everybody would like to know now. If somebody can answer, they can become central bank governor tomorrow. Okay, the question is getting vacant next month. And in fact, there is a tussle between Raghuram Rajan and Arvind Bayaram in bringing the policies to contain the exchange rate. So whoever brings the policies that contain the exchange rate, that will make RBI government. Okay. So that is the challenge.